Hello and welcome back to the channel, everyone. Follow us, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon for all the updates. So hello everyone, welcome back to the channel Pharmacology Simplified. In today's video, we are going to discuss the pharmacology and a bit about the pathophysiology or development of depression. So when we talk about depression, is a term we hear very frequently these days. And people have started to overuse the word depression. Even if they are feeling a bit sad, they start that they have undergone depression. This is not true. Depression is a very persistent depression in the mood, right? A person will feel sad, anhedonia, like they won't feel pleasure in anything. They won't feel happy at all in whatever things they do, right? And they will have suicidal tendencies developed over a period of time. They will feel worthlessness. They'll feel like no one is caring about them or they are not worthy of anything, right? So this is depression. And depression, it can be major depression or it can be bipolar, right? It can be major depression or bipolar depression. Like bipolar is like there will be too much swinging of the mood, right? One point there is sadness and here the individual is maniac. Like at one point of time the individual is so sad that you won't even feel like disturbing the individual. He's so sad, right? He will sit in a corner in the dark room. They will eat continuously, they will sleep for long hours, and at the other point they will become maniac. Maniac means like they are over a state of euphoria, right? They are in a state of euphoria. They will keep on shouting. They will not sleep. They will become hyperactive, right? And major depression is like when the individual is constantly for a very long duration of depressed state, right? The reason behind development of depression is like when these individuals they feel sad, and when there is a reduction in the levels of excitatory neurotransmitters in the brain, or where there is that can be due to their less synthesis or due to their increased metabolism, right? So now we will discuss about how the depression develops and what are the neurotransmitters that are responsible for development of depression, and after that we will discuss the drugs that are used in depression. So now if you see how depression develops in individuals, so as I said previously, that depression develops due to the lack of excitatory neurotransmitters in the brain. That can be due to their impaired release or due to their excessive reuptake or maybe due to their higher metabolism. So here we have identified a few targets that can be actually utilized for managing depression, right? So the primary neurotransmitters that are involved in pathophysiology depression are 5-HT, that's serotonin, noradrenaline, right? So these are the mainly these are important. Now what happens, this 5-HT is released and bind to 5-HT and it produces excitation in the brain. Similarly, noradrenaline happens in the brain, right? Although acetylcholine plays an important role in the memory, that's why I have mentioned it here also. So now we see that how we can use different drugs that will help us in improving the depression condition, right? So what we can do, like we cannot synthesize 5-HT. So what we do, we reduce the reuptake. Like this 5-HT, after its action is done, it is reuptaken back by SERT into the synaptic cleft. And this noradrenaline is reuptaken by this NET in the brain, right? So now what we will do, like if we inhibit the reuptake of this 5-HT, if we inhibit the reuptake of this noradrenaline, what will happen? They will lead to increased concentration of these two neurotransmitters in the synapse. Likewise, this monoamine oxidase, it leads to the metabolic breakdown of both of these neurotransmitters. So what if we inhibit these monoamine oxidases also? Correct. So here we have, what we have done through these mechanisms, we have improved or we have increased the availability of these excitatory neurotransmitters in the synapse, that will lead to the elevation in the mood and the depressed condition will be relieved. So now the drugs that do this, we have for blocking this 5-HT reuptake, we have the drugs with us. We have SSRIs. These are selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. For this, we have SNRIs. These are serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors, and they also act at this position. Next, we have monoamine oxidase, MAO inhibitors. So MAO inhibitors, what they will do, these MAO inhibitors, the drugs are MAO-A inhibitors primarily that we use. So they will act at the both places, right? Then we also have another class of drugs that are called as your TCA. These are your tricyclic antidepressants. What these do? They also inhibit the reuptake of these neurotransmitters, right? So, but tricyclic antidepressants are not that effective, right? They are not that effective, and hence they are replaced by newer drugs that are your SNRIs and SSRIs. One more thing, like why I have mentioned this histamine receptor and cholinergic receptors. These tricyclic antidepressants, they block these receptors. Tricyclic antidepressants, they block your histaminergic and cholinergic receptors, and because of this blockade, they produce sedation. And because of this cholinergic blockade, they produce anticholinergic effects like dry mouth, and they can also call amnesia, right? People will become forgetful, right? So these are the various targets that we can use. And the other one more class of the drug is there, that are atypical antidepressants. What they do? They block this 5-HT reuptake, but they are not used that frequently now. So now we will discuss individually every class of the drugs. The antidepressants are very important from pharmacological as well as your examination point of view. So now we will discuss the drugs individually. So I'm not going to discuss each and every drug, but I would be discussing the prototype drugs of every class, right? So like I just mentioned before, that there are four primary targets that we have identified that are used for management of depression. So these targets are your serotonin reuptake, noradrenaline reuptake, and monoamine oxidase. So the drugs are mainly of four classes we have divided. The first drugs are the SSRIs, or selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. These are the drugs that inhibit the reuptake of serotonin into the presynaptic neuron, that leads to increased availability of serotonin in the synaptic cleft. So the prototype drug of this class is fluoxetine, and this drug is more effective than the tricyclic antidepressants. Moreover, these drugs do not have any anticholinergic or antihistaminergic effect. As a result, they do not cause symptoms like dry mouth, blurred vision, and they do not also cause sedation, right? And since they are not interacting with many systems of the body, they have better safety profile, and they do not produce postural hypotension, right? Postural hypotension is like whenever there is change in the posture, our blood pressure rises or decreases or falls in response to the change in the posture. Sometimes what happens, whenever we change our body posture, the blood pressure does not rise to the levels to which it is required, and hence the supply of the blood to the brain, it gets reduced, and hence postural hypotension occurs. You might have felt it like if you are lying down And if you get up suddenly, then there are chances that you feel dizzy for a second. So this is the time period during which our heart is adjusting the blood pressure so that our brain gets sufficient amount of blood to work, right? These drugs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, they inhibit the cytochrome enzymes CYP2D6 and CYP3A4. These are the enzymes that are responsible for metabolism of a number of drugs. So what happens when these enzymes are inhibited, then this leads to the increased level of those drugs that are metabolized by these enzymes. So for example, like haloperidol, warfarin are the drugs that are metabolized through this enzyme, and their plasma levels can rise in the blood. The adverse effects are they lead to nightmares and dreaming, and one most important is serotonin syndrome. Right, serotonin syndrome is nothing but whenever there is excessive amount of serotonin in the body, then it leads to development of serotonin syndrome. It leads by agitation, a person feel irritated, hyperactive sometimes, and this happens when a person who is consuming SSRIs also consumes monoamine oxidase inhibitors. So through this we are increasing the level of serotonin in the synapse, and through this this monoamine oxidase, what we are doing, we are inhibiting the metabolism of serotonin. So the very high levels of serotonin they lead to serotonin syndrome. The next class of the drug are SNRIs. SNRIs stand for serotonin noradrenaline reuptake inhibitors. The prototype drug of this class is venlafaxine. This drug is more effective because it is affecting on both the neurotransmitters. It is inhibiting the reuptake of serotonin as well as of norepinephrine. So these drugs are more effective than SSRIs, as I have just said, and they have fewer adverse effects since the doses that are given to patients are relatively lesser than the monotherapy. And these drugs are also non-cholinergic and non-histaminergic, so they show less interactions, and as a result, they do not show any sedation in the subjects who are taking these drugs. The next class of the drug is like, this was a very widely used class of the antidepressants before these SSRIs and SNRIs came into the picture. So these are TCAs or tricyclic antidepressants, as the name suggests that they have three cycles in their structure, chemical structure, and they are differentiated, they are classified into two groups. First is this your 5-HT and norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors. They have the drugs imipramine, amitriptyline and dothepin. Some other drugs are also there, but I have mentioned only a few. And then we have the preferential 5-HT reuptake inhibitors. The drug in this class is desimipramine, right? These are not complete inhibitors, or they do not inhibit the reuptake of 5-HT NA or 5-HT to a higher degree as compared to these, right? What they do, they slow down the reuptake process. So the availability of 5-HT and noradrenaline is increased in the synapse, but the results are better obtained with SSRIs and SNRIs, right? And these drugs are strong anticholinergics, and these drugs are antihistaminergics, right? They're very strong anticholinergics, very strong antihistaminics. As a result, they cause sedation, and they also develop demented conditions. They also produce amnesia, like people start to forget things, because acetylcholine plays a vital role in the memory process. And yes, these drugs also, they lower the seizure threshold, right? So if TCAs or tricyclic antidepressants are administered by any individual in a high dose, then we can expect that seizures may be precipitated, or seizures may be seen in an individual, right? And the last class of the drug are the monoamine A inhibitor, MAO-A inhibitors. The drugs are clozaline and meclobemide. What these drugs do, in the presynaptic neuron, in the previous content that was present on the board, we had seen that monoamine oxidase A, MAO-A, is an enzyme that is present on the mitochondria of the cell. So what happens, it inhibits that MAO-A. So MAO-A, what it does, it is monoamine oxidase. So what it does, it metabolizes 5-HT and noradrenaline both, right? So it is MAO-A inhibitors are not interacting with the transportation of 5-HT or noradrenaline, but what they are doing, they are inhibiting their metabolism. As a result, the concentration of both of these, it increases, right, in the presynaptic neurons, and hence their release is promoted, right? And like these MAO-A, I have already discussed that they can lead to development of serotonin syndrome in a few individuals. Along with that, they also cause cheese reaction, right? If someone eats food that is rich in tyramine or DOPA, like fish or cheese, so then what happens? There is massive release of noradrenaline in the body, and as a result of which, there is rapid increase in the blood pressure that leads to hypertension, and that is called as cheese reaction, and that can cause hypertensive crisis, right? There is one more class of antidepressants that are atypical antidepressants, but they are not found very effective nowadays, and they used to work by blocking the 5-HT reuptake, but now what has happened, since we have got the better drugs, better pharmacological agents for the management of depression, so we are rarely using those drugs anymore. Right. So with this, I would like to put an end to this video. If you have been able to understand anything out of this video, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, share the video as much as possible, and happy learning to all of us. Thank you very much.